Hey, what's up, what's good? Welcome back once again to another reaction. We're gonna react into the new episode that came out of Don't Toy Me, Miss Nagatoro. Episode came out a couple hours ago. Now, last week's episode was pretty interesting. I thought it was pretty cool, it was pretty funny. First half of the episode, we obviously had Senpai having like a dream, I guess, or should I say like a nightmare or whatever. He basically got isekai to another world and shit, and he was supposed to save it. And obviously we saw that Nagatoro was there in his dream or whatever, and he was supposed to take out the demon lord or whatever. And towards the end, it was actually revealed that Nagatoro, Gaamo, and Yoshi were actually the were the they were the demon lords basically. So I kind of found that funny, you know, like he kind of sees them as demon lords or whatever, which makes sense because of the way they treated him or whatever. So it kind of makes sense that he sees him in that light, I guess, sort of say. And then in the second half of the episode, it was pretty funny as well. They kind of went to the beach or whatever, and I thought it was funny, especially when they were trying to like put sunscreen on him or whatever, and then they all started stepping on him and shit. It was pretty hilarious episode nonetheless. I enjoyed it. And anyway, let's just hop into this one, and let's see what's up. Here we go. So it looks like they're like at some kind of festival or whatever. Thought that was Nagatoro or whatever. He kind of confused her with her or whatever. She kind of looks similar, like from like the back and shit. Ah, bro, you better run, bro, run, duck, zigzag, get out of there. They got him, bro. They got him on a fucking leash. That's fucked up. She's over there chilling with her club and shit. She's beginning out of shape for real, bro. I gained so much weight myself. It's not even funny. Me and Nagatoro are the same, I guess. She's gonna go with the quickness, I bet you ain't. There she goes right there, bro. She's got them yandere tendencies, I'm telling you. End it early. Let's see. What's she gonna say? Call it. Look. Oh, I thought she was gonna give him more piss, but it doesn't look like it. He's like, take this shit off for real, bro. Like, give me. She's like, give me. And she's like, nah, fuck that. Oh, you had to fight for him, huh? It looks like they're gonna compete. I don't think they're actually gonna fight. But who knows, knowing them too, the way they always clash and shit, I wouldn't be surprised. Look at Yoshi and Senpai were funny. He's like, of course not, bro. She's got good fucking aim. Bullseye. In more ways than one, bullseye because you hit the target, and bullseye because you know that he wanted to invite her. Was that like a ring toss? It is a ring toss. I heard that those things are hard to do when you try to catch like the little fish with the net and shit. We won. It looks like they got more things, but Nagatoro's got that big ass one. See what I'm saying? Yeah, the other one's got a bunch of small little things, but she's got that big one, so who knows? Not enough to make up for numbers. It's a rare item, though. I think she wants it. It looks like she did want it, bro. She bought her off. I knew it. She's like, you bought her off. He's over there like, take this shit off of you, bro. That's fucking hilarious. He's like, get this fucking shit off of me. The fireworks are starting. She's like, hurry up, bro. The fireworks are going on. I haven't gone to see fireworks in the longest time, bro. I think it's been like fucking, what, like 8 years or so since the last time I went to go see fireworks. Something sleazy, like, oh, he's trying to put her on the spot. That's fucking funny, bro. He's turning the tables on her. He's like, no, don't tell me. Give me more specifics. Exact term. He's not turning the tables on her. Oh shit, he wasn't expecting that. She turned the tables back on him, bro. You never had a chance. Oh, he's trying to turn the tables back. This is fucking hilarious, bro. The interaction, they're trying to turn the tables on each other. They're gonna see everybody else making out. Oh, she has like the makeout spot. They're gonna get the fuck out of there. That's fucking hilarious. They were trying to turn the tables on each other. She does not want to be near this dude whatsoever, bro. It looks like Yoshi wants none of it either. Oh, that's that girl. That's the girl from the first episode. No, she's not feeling it. She's like, get the fuck off me, bro. Oh, he's fucking jealous. Oh shit. Senpai's about to go put him in check real quick. Maybe not. Maybe not, bro. You see the way fucking Nagatoro's face is lit up right there? Oh, come on, bro. You gotta... Finally, I was about to say, come on, bro. You gotta show you got some backbone or something. Is he gonna say it again? Oh, he didn't have to. She said it for him. Yeah, see, that's her right there. He draws pervy manga. Draw manga, but it's not hentai. He's fucking hilarious. He's like, you got a weird vibe, bro. Hey, but she's not insulting him like the other ones. She said you got a weird vibe, but she's not like, she's not throwing out insults. That's fucking hilarious. He's like, I don't fit in here. Hey, Carlson. He's like, I don't fit in there, but he looks like he fits in there fine. Like, chilling with them. They're having a good time. Oh, what I was about to say, I was like, hey, he's like hella like, he was actually able to like, I don't know how to say it. Like, he has no confidence in himself or whatever, but hey, he was able to pull all four of them away from them other two dudes. Anyways, alright, so here we go. So that was my reaction to this episode. It was a pretty good episode. The first half of the episode, we obviously had that, they were at that festival or whatever, and we saw that that Gamo and Yoshi actually found Senpai. He was actually hoping to find Nagatoro, but he actually was found by Gamo and Yoshi, and they kind of put a collar in him or whatever. And then they took a selfie and they sent it to Nagatoro, which obviously she fucking booked it to where they were at, you know, she ran, which makes sense, you know, because she's like very protective of him. And then they kind of competed for each other, which I thought was, they kind of competed for, I guess, who gets to, I guess, keep Senpai or whatever, I guess if that's the way you want to put it. It was a pretty good episode. We saw them going back and forth, and basically we saw that Nagatoro basically said, told Senpai, hey, if you want to hang out with me, you just got to ask, like, you know, which is pretty cool to see, you know, that she's actually like, kind of like, I feel like she's kind of throwing him hints or whatever, you know, that she might like him or whatever, but he's not really picking up on them. And then it was a, I thought it was really funny when they went to go see the fireworks with their little interactions where they were trying to turn the tables on each other. Like, each of them were trying to put each other on the spot and kind of make the other one embarrassed, which I thought was pretty funny. First it was Nagatoru trying to put him on the spot, and then Senpai flipped the tables on her, and they kept going back and forth, which I thought was funny. And then when like the fireworks lit up like the surrounding area, they saw that I guess that was like a make-out area or whatever. They saw a bunch of people making out, which kind of put them both on the spot, and they got hella shy and they fucking ran away. I thought that was hilarious. And then we also saw again, we also saw once again that Nagatoro does not want anything to do with, like, I guess, from what we've seen, and even when she, from what she said, she does not like being around men, I'm guessing. I mean, I'm not saying that she doesn't like it, but she doesn't like when guys hit on her or whatever, because she's mentioned it before, you know, when, I think it was Yoshi, or I don't remember, one of her friends tried to set her up, like, on a blind date, and she basically said that she wasn't feeling it, and she wasn't having it or whatever. And then we kind of saw in the restaurant, like, she was kind of turned off by that one dude that was trying to hit on her. And here again, that one guy that kind of, like, threw his arms around her or whatever was trying to, like, I guess, hit on her or whatever. Like, she wasn't feeling it. Like, she was just trying to get the fuck out of there. And then when she saw Senpai, like, her face just lit up and shit. Which, once again, goes to show that she actually likes him. But, I just find it funny that, like, whenever she's around other dudes, she's, like, she's just not, like, she does not want to be there. Like, she almost, like, she's, like, she's like completely turned off, and she's kind of like get the fuck away from me or whatever. But when we, well, but when she's been sent by, like, her whole personality changes basically. I think that's pretty interesting. And then towards the episode, we saw that one girl again, the one from like the first episode. I don't remember seeing her in the previous episode. I think we saw her in the last, I think we did see her in last week's episode, but only for like a short amount of time. She was like the girl in the in his dream, you know, the one that pushed him off to like the. When he got isekai in his dream, the girl that was wearing like the, was she wearing like a hoodie if I remember correctly? The one that showed them off basically. I think that's like the only time we've seen her besides the first episode if I remember correctly. Anyways, but we seen her again, and she actually wasn't like, she wasn't bullying him like the other, like obviously Naruto bullies him all the time, but she does that because she likes him. And then we know that Yoshi and Gamo bullying him as well, but this other girl, she kind of wasn't bullying him, so that was pretty, that was, I guess, like a nice little change of pace or whatever. Anyways, the episode was pretty dope. I enjoyed it. Catch you guys on the next one. Take it easy and bye.